Now, I will try to explain error recovery strategy in non-recursive design parser. I will explain panic mode error recovery strategy. We know we shall have an LL1 parsing table and we shall have a string to which we have to parse. We shall have a stack. One stack is there and one string is there. Some string is there. This is a string and this is a stack. We shall have some terminals and non-terminals in this stack and we shall have string here. If some terminal is here in this string and some non-terminal is here on the top of the string, and we find that there is no entry in LL1 parsing table for that symbol and for that symbol on that non-terminal, then there are three options: either pop this non-terminal from the system or discard this symbol from this string. Discard means pop it, take away from this symbol from the string, or introduce another non-terminal in the stack by which this symbol is produced. The third strategy is not meaningful because we shall introduce the symbols from the starting symbol. If it is not coming into the picture, then there is no, this is not feasible to introduce new symbol. So we have, I am writing here, there are three strategies, there are three options. First one is pop non-terminal from the stack. Second one is discard or remove the terminal from the string. And third one is introduce the non-terminal by which that terminal can be produced. This third strategy is not meaningful, so we shall not use it. We shall not use this option. Okay, now before going to discuss when to pop non-terminal from the stack and when to discard terminal from the string, we shall have in LL1 parsing table, we shall have some grammar here. I am taking one grammar here. He is producing P E dash. E dash is producing plus P dash or epsilon. I'm taking minus T dash also.
t is given f t dash, t dash is given s star f t dash or slash f t dash or epsilon, f is given in bracket e or some identifier. So before going to discuss LLM parsing table, we shall have to find first and foremost sets of this grammar, and we have already found first and follow sets of this grammar. Here we shall find first and follow sets of this grammar. Okay, I'm changing this grammar. I will take some different grammar. F is giving g g dash, and g is giving s freak f or epsilon, and this g is giving in bracket e or some identifier. Okay, so we shall find first and follow sets. Now I will write here. First set here. Follow set. In first, we shall find first sets of non-terminals to which we can easily write here. This is g dash, not g. G is here. So first set of g is this open bracket and here identifier. First set of g dash is this arrow and here epsilon. First of f is dependent on g, so we shall see later. First of t dash is asterisk from here, from this production we shall get this is star, and if we use this production there will be slash, and if we use this production it will be epsilon. It is also dependent on f. Here first of e dash will be plus, if you use this production, and minus if we use this production, and epsilon if we use this production. Okay, now first of f is same as first of g, which is open bracket and id, and first of t is same as first of f, which is open bracket and id. First of e is same as first of t, which is open bracket and id. These are the first sets. Now we have to find the follow sets. Follow of e. E is the star symbol, so it's a follow will be dollar always. Star symbols follow is always zero dollar, and we shall see where else e is coming. E is coming here, so it's a follow is e dash. Sorry, this closed bracket. Now we have to find the follow of e dash. Follow of e dash is same as follow of e, which is dollar and closed bracket. Now follow of t. Follow of t will be same as first of e dash. What is first of e dash? first of E dash is plus minus and epsilon. So plus is here, minus is here. If I replace this E dash by epsilon, then this will be the rightmost non-terminal because E dash will be vanished. Now these follow will be same as that of E dash. So follow of E dash is dollar and closed bracket. So I am writing here dollar and closed bracket. Whereas E dash is coming, here, here. Same thing is there. So no problem. Sorry, T dash. No, T is coming here and here. In both the cases, same thing will come. Now, T dash. Follow of F will be same as first of T dash. First of T dash is star slash. This is follow, this is first here. Okay, this is star slash. If I replace this T dash by epsilon, then follow of F will be same as follow of T dash, which is plus minus dollar and closed bracket. Where else F is coming? F is coming here. Follow of F will be same as follow of G dash also. So we shall see later what will be the follow of G dash. Follow of G dash will be same as that of F, and follow of F will be same as that of G dash. Both are dependent. So follow of F is this, and follow of G dash will also be same as that of F, which will be asterisk slash plus minus n dollar. Now we have to find the follow of G. Follow of G will be same as first of G dash. First of G dash is asterisk. Sorry, this arrow. And if I replace this G dash by epsilon, then follow of G will be same as that of F. So I'm writing here asterisk division plus minus dollar and closed bracket. These are the first and follow sets G dash. G dash. Yes. G dash. Yes. Definitely it will be closed bracket. Yeah. We shall write terminals here. Sorry, non-terminals here. E dash T T dash F G dash and G. Now we have terminals. Open bracket. I'm writing here. Open bracket. Closed bracket. Open bracket. Closed bracket. Plus minus. Star slash arrow open bracket closed bracket star arrow and identifier is also there. Identifier and is dollar. Open bracket, identifier, plus minus is there, star slash is there, arrow is there. Okay. Now, E, if we need open bracket, we shall have only one option because we have this production only. E produces T E dash, so I will write here, E produces T E dash. If identifier is needed, then I have only one option, E produces T E produces T E dash. If I need plus, then E dash here, I will write here, E dash produces plus T E dash. If I need minus sign, I will use this production, E dash will produce minus T E dash. Epsilon is there. If I need epsilon, then dollar and closed bracket, I will write here, E dash produces epsilon, and at dollar, E dash produces epsilon. Here, first of T, if open bracket is needed, I will write here, T produces FT dash, because one choice is there, and if I need identifier, I have only one choice, T produces FT dash. T produces FT dash. And in T dash, if I need star, then I will write here, T dash produces star FT dash. If I need slash, I will write here, T dash produces slash FT dash. Epsilon is there. So epsilon production will be written in follow part. So I will write here in follow, plus is there. So T dash produces epsilon, minus is there, T dash produces epsilon, dollar is there, T dash produces epsilon, closed bracket is there, T dash produces epsilon. Now, F, first of F is open bracket and identifier. If I need open bracket, I have one choice only, GG dash. So, F produces GG dash. If I need identifier, I have only one choice, F produces G G dash, G dash. If I need arrow, I will use this production, G dash arrow. If I need G dash arrow, G dash will produce arrow F. Epsilon is also there in the first, so in this part, at star, I will write G dash produces epsilon slash G dash produces epsilon plus G dash produces epsilon minus G dash produces epsilon dollar G dash produces epsilon. Closed bracket, G dash produces epsilon. Now G, first of G is open bracket, so I will write here, if I need open bracket, I will use this production, so I will write here, G produces open bracket E. If I need identifier, then in this column I will write here, G will produce identifier. Blank entries are errors. Now, we shall fill these entries
we shall check what to do here. Okay? Now, this closed bracket is there. We shall see whether this closed bracket is coming in follow of E or not. If it is in the follow of E, I will write here, I will pop this E from the stack. So I am writing here pop. Plus is not in the follow of plus, in follow of E. So I will discard the symbol from string. Discard means I will ignore that symbol. So I will write here for discarding symbol from the string, I will write it scan. Minus is also not there, so I will write scan. Product is also not there, scan. Division is also not there, then scan. Arrow is also not there, scan. Dollar is there, then you have to pop the non-terminal from the stack. E dash, open bracket. Open bracket is not there, so you have to scan. Okay, now asterisk is also not there. Asterisk is not there, so it means you have to discard it. Scan. Slash is not there. Scan. Arrow is not there. Scan. Identifier is not there. Then you have to scan. In T, closed bracket. T closed bracket. This T is here. Closed bracket is in a, it's a follow. So you have to pop the non-terminal from the stack. Pop. Plus is in the follow, so you have to pop. Minus is there, so you have to pop. Asterisk is not there, you have to scan. Slash is not there, you have to scan. Okay, yes. Arrow is not there, you have to scan. Dollar is there, so you have to pop. Now, T dash. Open bracket is not there, so you have to scan. Arrow is not there, so you have to scan. Identifier is not there, so you have to scan. In F, closed bracket is there, so you have to pop. Plus is here, so you have to pop. Minus is here, so you have to pop. Asterisk is here, you have to pop. Slash is here, you have to pop. Arrow is not here, so you have to scan, you have to discard it. And dollar is here, and dollar is also here in F, so you have to pop. Now, G dash, open bracket is not there, so you have to, and identifier is also not there, you have to scan it. Here, closed bracket is here, so you have to pop the non-terminal from the stack. And plus is here, you have to pop it.
minus is here, you have to pop it. Asterisk is here, you have to pop it. Slash is here, pop. Arrow is also here, so you have to pop. And dollar is here, you have to pop. So this is the table here. Now we shall discuss one example. Here, parsing stack is here, one string is given here. Now, there are some entries in the LL1 parsing table. I'm writing here LL1 parsing table. At top, it's a T, and in the string, star is here. T and star intersecting cell. It is saying scan. Scan means you have to discard the symbol from this string, so no symbol is there. Now using T, you have to find closed bracket. T closed bracket. Pop. Pop means you have to pop this symbol from the top. E dash closed bracket. E dash closed bracket. Epsilon. You have to replace this E dash by epsilon. It means you have to pop it. This closed bracket, closed bracket. That is matching. So you have to. You have to pop this symbol from the. From the stack, and you have to remove the symbol from the string also. Now T dash dollar, T dash dollar, T dash dollar, replace this T dash by epsilon. It means you have to pop it. E dash by, you need dollar. E dash dollar, E dash dollar, you have to replace this E dash by epsilon. Means you have to pop it. Dollar dollar is matching. It means the string has been parsed. Now I will see some more examples. Here, this is the content of the parsing stack, and this is the string to be parsed. Now at the top we are seeing G is there, and here it is arrow. G and arrow intersecting cell. G and arrow intersecting cell, entry C is there, which is pop. Pop means you have to pop this symbol from the stack. Now T and arrow, T and arrow, it is scan. Scan means you have to discard it from the string. Now T to star, T to star. It is saying scan, it means you have to discard it. Now T2 closed bracket. T2 closed bracket is saying pop, so you have to pop it. F2 closed bracket. F2 closed bracket is pop, you have to pop it. E dash 2 closed bracket. E dash 2 closed bracket is saying replace E dash by epsilon, it means you have to pop it. Now closed bracket and closed bracket is matching, so you have to discard from the string as well as from the, you have to pop it from the stack. Now T dash 2 ID, T dash 2 ID, T dash 2 ID scan. Scan means you have to discard it from the string. Now T dash 2 dollar, T dash 2 dollar is saying replace T dash by epsilon, so pop it. E dash 2 dollar, replace E dash by epsilon, you have to pop it. Now dollar dollar, that has been matched. So this is the all about panic mode. Panic mode error recovery strategy.